Hello there, welcome to Blink & Beep. In this video, I will be reviewing the new electric water heater that I purchased for my home. So here's the product. It's from the famous brand V-Guard. The model name is Iris. The capacity is 3 liters and it has 2 years of warranty. Also, it has the ISA certificate. That is nice. So that is all is there in this side of the box. Let's get to the other side. Okay, so we have 3 items here. The first one says electric water heater with SS tank for long life. So SS means stainless steel. So you get long life for the interior parts of the heater, and sacrificial anode for extended lifespan. So what does sacrificial anode mean? Just as the name implies, this type of anode sacrifices itself, and hence it prevents corrosion to other parts of the inner tank in this water heater. So you might have a question as of what happens if the anode starts corroding. The answer is yes, the anode corrodes over usage. I did a little research, and what I found is that though it corrodes, the anode can function for years without any complication. So even after years of usage, the anode can be replaced with a new one. This way you get more life for a heater as a whole, and you don't have to put more money buying new heater. And instead, it can replace the new anode for much lesser amount. So to me, that is a very good option, and I would definitely go for it. And the third one here says replacement warranty 5 years for inner tank. So that's for the inner tank. That's again a good thing. So below here is a message from the company to the owners who purchased this product. There's no technical detail, so we'll skip it and move to the next side of the box. Okay, so here we have the product specifications. Commodity electric water heater, model Iris, capacity 3 liters, wattage, the important one, it's 3 kWa, so it's 3 kilowatts, and which means it's really powerful. And other things like year of packaging, retail price, and customer care info. So let's skip that. And the next important thing here is the color. So the color is ivory, pretty much of a neutral color. So that's all we have on the box. Now it's time to unbox it. So after unboxing, I will show around the product a bit, and probably there is nothing much to show before installing the item. So probably after the installation, I will show you how much space it occupies and how it performs in real time in the same video. So that's the operating manual and warranty card. Here's the product. Looks neat. And down below we have two indicators. One is for the mains and other one which says heating. That's pretty much it. As you can see, it also fits very much in the hand, and it's very lightweight. So the reason why I say this is this gives an idea of about how big the product is, so that you know, if you need to know that before you buy that, the inlet and the outlet. So that's pretty much it for now. So let me show you the details once I install the product, and hopefully I can give a round of testing.
Okay guys, the installation is done, and here is the heater. As you can see, it takes very less space, and moreover, this is a low roof bathroom, and still it fits without any disturbances. That is one important reason for me to go for an instant heater. So now let's get with the proceedings. I'm gonna switch it on. Yep, the main is on and the heating indication is up. I also have my stopwatch here. So just to see how long it takes. So as you can see now, both the mains and the heating LEDs are on. And once the water gets heated, the heating indication should turn off. We will check that right away. Okay guys, so now the heating has turned off, and it has approximately taken me around 3.5 seconds, I mean 3.5 minutes. So so now that the indication is off, we will check the water temperature from the tap. So change of setup needed here. I hope that's visible. As you can see, the temperature is really high. That's because we gave the heater some time to heat the water in its storage to its maximum capacity before we open the tap. Now let's allow some water to flow out, and we will check the temperature again. Yeah, so now the water has been flowing for some time, and now the temperature has dropped, that's actually because the water was flowing continuously, and that's inevitable. The reason I think is that it's the capacity of this heater. So it has 3 liters of storage, so more water, and so it takes more time to heat the water on the go. But I have been using this heater for around a week, and I don't feel that as an issue. Because anyway, we have to be using that with the hot water with a mixer, so it's not always directly the only the hot water that you're going to use, so that shouldn't be a problem. But if you think you need more temperature on the go as well, we could reduce the speed of the water tap. So now I have set the tap to half open position. Just to show you guys how the temperature varies when we open the tap like half or less. There you go. So all that it needs is that we just don't have to open the tap to its full capacity.
One more tip is that try to place the heater as close as possible to the tap or the mixer. That way the water flows a shorter path, and that might actually help you to get a little boost to the temperature, since the water won't lose its temperature while flowing through the pipe connection. So after a week's use, I feel that this completely fits my usage needs. I don't have to think again about waiting for the water to get heated as in my old regular water heater. So basically you don't miss your schedule forgetting to turn on the heater on time. So that can be a lifesaver to many people like me. I am really happy with this product. Hope you like it as well. So with that, we come to the end of this video. Hope this was a helpful one. More videos in my channel. Please do watch them and subscribe if you like to watch more reviews and unboxing. Kindly comment if anything needs to be improved or for any points that you think I missed. Your feedback is really valuable to me. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Bye.